What are oceans? Oceans are huge areas of salt water that cover about 70% of the Earth's surface and contain almost 98% of all the Earth's water. Ocean water is salty because of something called sodium chloride, which is dissolved in the water. There are five oceans. From largest to smallest, they are the Pacific, the Atlantic, the Indian, the Southern, or Antarctic, and the Arctic. How deep are the oceans? Oceans have many levels. The shallowest part of an ocean is called the continental shelf, which lies along the edges of a continent. The continental shelf slopes down toward the deep parts of the ocean, called the basin. Some parts of the oceans have deep cracks in the ocean floor, called trenches. Some oceans have underwater mountain chains, called oceanic ridges. Because the ocean floor is not flat, ocean depths vary, but the average depth of the ocean is about 3,682 meters. The deepest ocean is the Pacific Ocean, and its deepest part is found in the Mariana Trench, at a place called Challenger Deep, which is about 10,935 meters deep. What is in the oceans? Oceans are full of living things. Ocean plants need sunlight to live, so they grow close to the water's surface. The most common ocean plants are called phytoplankton, which are tiny plants that drift with the ocean currents. Sea grass and seaweeds also grow in the world's oceans. Corals and sea anemones look like plants, but they are actually animals. Most ocean animals also live in the shallower waters, where they can feed on the plants and other animals near the surface. There are thousands of different types of animals that live in the oceans, such as fish, dolphins, sharks, seals, lobsters, jellyfish, and sea turtles. The blue whale is the largest ocean animal and also the largest animal on Earth. What are tides and currents? The levels of the oceans rise and fall twice every day. These are called tides, which are caused by the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun and the rotation of the Earth. The highest level is called high tide, and the lowest level is called low tide. Ocean water moves around the Earth constantly in definite patterns called currents. Surface currents are caused by wind blowing across the surface of the water, creating waves. Deep water currents are caused by temperature changes, salt levels, gravity, and density. These currents are warm or cold and affect the Earth's climate. Cold currents come from the poles and cause a cold, dry climate on nearby land. Warm ocean currents come from the equator and bring warm weather and rain to land. For example, the Gulfstream current pulls warm water and weather from the equator to the coast of Western Europe. What are seas? Seas are parts of the oceans which are almost totally or partly surrounded by land. There are more than 50 seas on Earth. Seas that are almost totally surrounded by land, like the Mediterranean Sea, are connected to oceans by narrow waterways called straits. These straits limit the movement of water between seas and oceans. This means that these seas do not have tides or water like the oceans. For example, the Red Sea is much saltier than the Indian Ocean, and some of the fish that live there are not found in any other seas or oceans. Seas that are only partly surrounded by land are more like the oceans. For example, the Weddell Sea in Antarctica is linked to the ocean by a wide opening and has similar tides and organisms to the Atlantic Ocean. Seas that are completely surrounded by land are called hypersaline lakes, which means there is a lot of salt in their waters, for example, the Caspian Sea, between Europe and Asia. Did you know? People who study the oceans are called oceanographers. They study the water, the seafloors and basins, and the plants and animals that live there. Our oceans are full of pollution, which reduces oxygen in the water and harms ocean life. Overfishing and oil spills also damage the oceans and the plants and animals that live in them. The world's oceans are very important to life on Earth, as phytoplankton and algae produce much of the world's oxygen. Oceans also help to keep climate stable by storing heat from the sun.